Dentro, last year, the 160,000 Irish people attracted the left bank today. It was headed a good Irish fire in the Second World War London on the East Treaty in 2009. The Irish government were given a decisive mandate to return to their European partners and negotiate a better deal for the people of Ireland, Europe, and the wider world. So what did our government do? As little as possible. This time, they advised e-letters to ignore the concerns of Irish people and to continue the ratification process. Our Taoiseach, Brian Horan, sat in his hands for 5 months, and then, at the 11th hour, made a handful of his EU Board of Works and out of the Sunday European Council meeting in Brussels. At that council meeting, the government committed itself to rerunning the Lisbon Treaty for a second time. In return, they agreed to a deal that the EU leaders agreed not to reduce the size of the European Commission for the time being, and sign a small number of guarantees and a small number of issues. However, the government of a spinning electric in their description of this deal. Modifying the Lisbon Treaty would give away our automatic rights to our commissioner. The government still may see the commissioner remain for an unspecified amount of time, but the power to reduce the terms of the commission will be given to the council. And sooner rather than later, we will see an end to one commissioner per member state. Equally, guarantees or declarations are not legally binding. They do not represent legal status as compared to the treaty or protocols to a treaty. They are merely legal guarantees made by politicians with no legal status or authority. They are like the promises of a government or the election plan made only to the government. More fundamentally, the deal outlined by the government in Brussels does not address the substantive issues raised by the electorate. The broader issue of the European Union's democratic deficit, its erosion of workers' rights and public services, its emerging form of defense policy agendas, and its promotion of free trade over fair trade will not be addressed. The people of Ireland and Europe deserve better than the Lisbon Treaty. We need a new treaty for new times. The context against which the national debate on the Lisbon Treaty ratified process has changed. Ireland is now in recession. The economy is plummeting forward, and the government has no clue what to turn things around. The government is certainly hoping to play on the ups and downs of people by arguing that Ireland's economic woes are because we were attacked at Lisbon. They tell us that our international reputation has been damaged. Our international reputation was damaged last April when Bulgaria ran gets the same and bitter charges of corruption. It was again damaged when the government nationalized the most corrupt bank in this state, Anglo-Irish Bank. Last report, Ireland's reputation has been damaged by decades of free-to-fall corruption. It has been damaged because free-to-fall left governments who failed the French economy that benefited those in their golden circle and failed you and me. Our superior policies of improper markets, de-organization and privatization and a scale to recession in Ireland and Europe. Successive free-to-fall-led governments like the European counterparts not only support these policies, but also promote them. One deal on the market from TV's name. One of the cornerstones of Barack Obama's successful campaign for the presidency of the United States of America was confronting the principle of vested interests Thank you.